Hello friends, today we are going to solve some GATE previous year's question from the chapter Welding. Now we can see that this is a GATE 2014 question. Now we will read the question. In the question, what they are asking is the major difficulty during welding of aluminium. See, the metal they have mentioned in this question is aluminium. So what is the problem with aluminium? Aluminium is basically a metal which has very high affinity for oxygen, and when it is in contact with oxygen during heating or in the presence of temperature, it forms aluminium oxide. So what's the problem with aluminium oxide? Basically, aluminium oxide is a brittle in nature. So as soon as we start welding aluminium, it forms aluminium oxide, which is brittle material, and when thermal stresses are provided, it starts breaking. So the whole purpose of welding of aluminium gets defeated. So in order to weld aluminium, metal like aluminium, it should be done in an inert atmosphere. So the main problem with welding of aluminium is its high affinity for oxygen. So the correct answer is its high tendency of oxidation. Option A is the correct answer. Now going to the next question. So see, we can see that this question is again from GATE 2014. So what they are seeing in this question, they are asking in a solid state welding, the contamination layers between the surfaces to be welded are removed by. See friends, this is basically a theoretical question, and I must say that you should go through theory very properly. I won't be able to explain in detail how the contamination layers between the surfaces are removed. I can only say you the correct answer, which is B. It is basically removed due to the plastic deformation. Please go through the theory for this particular question. Now friends, going to the next question. So this is again a GATE question from the year 2014. So we can see that this is a numerical type question. So what I will do, I will first read the question and then mention all the datas, and then I will try to solve it. So what they are asking in this question, they have mentioned for spot welding. See, they have mentioned it's a spot welding method. The metal sheets are there, that is steel metal sheets are there. They have mentioned the thickness, which is 3 mm. So they have mentioned the thickness as 3 mm. Now what they have mentioned, that welding current of 1000 amperes. See, 1000 ampere current. So we can write 1000 ampere current is applied for 0.2 seconds. Time period is also given, that is 0.2 second. Now what they are saying, that the heat dissipated to the base metal is 1000 joules. So basically heat dissipated, I am denoting it by H suffix D, is 1000 joule. Now what they are saying, assuming that the heat required for melting 1 mm cube volume of steel is 20 joule. So they have given the heat required per mm cube for melting, which is 20 joule per mm cube. Now they have also given the interfacial contact resistance, which is 0.0002 ohm. So R is 0.0002 ohm. Now what they are asking is the volume of the weld nugget. So they have asked basically the volume. So first I will try to calculate the heat generated. So we can calculate it by using the formula I square RT. It's a very basic formula from electrical engineering. So you can use this formula and solve, that is 10,000 whole square into resistance, which is 0.0002 into the time period, which is 0.2 seconds. So when I will calculate, the heat generated comes as 4000 joule. So now what they are saying, I am assuming, since they haven't mentioned that the heat transfer efficiency is 100% or not, so I am assuming that the heat transfer after dissipation, see they have mentioned dissipation, so some part of the heat is dissipated, HD is 1000 joule. So the heat transferred in the weld is, I am noting HT is equals to 4000 minus of 1000, which is 3000 joule. Now this heat is completely used for welding. I am assuming that none other part of this heat is being dissipated anywhere, either to the atmosphere, because they haven't mentioned anything about those things. So now 3000 is heat transfer to the weld. So now what is the volume? Since they have mentioned that 20 joule per m cube is required to melt, so the volume of the weld is 3000 joule by 20 joule per m cube, which will give volume as 150 mm cube. So this is the correct answer. Since they have asked the volume in mm cube only, so the right answer is 150. Now moving to the next question. So friends, this is again a theoretical question, and it is from GATE 2014 only. So what they have asked, within the heat affected zone in a fusion welding process, see, the welding process is fusion welding, the work material undergoes, see, basically in a heat affected zone, which is written as HAZ, the grain structure changes, or we can say the boundaries deform, the boundaries changes, and in heat affected zone there is no such melting of the metal. So as a whole, I can say that in heat affected zone there is the change in the microstructure. So when we go to the options, they are saying microstructural changes. Yes, it's a possibility. Neither melting nor no, it's not the possibility. Both melting and microstructural changes, after all, it's a possibility. Melting and retains, no, it's not the possibility. We are having options A and C. Now, since in a heat affected zone there is no melting, there is no actual melting of the metal, so the correct answer in this question is option A, because it says but doesn't melt. So the right answer is option A. Option C also gets eliminated. Now moving to the next question. So now we can see that this question is again from GATE 2014. So this is again a theoretical question. Now first I will read the question. What they are saying is that a butt weld joint is developed on steel plates having yield and ultimate tensile strength of 500 MPa and 700 MPa. So what they are saying that there is a butt weld, joint. So first I am trying to draw a butt weld joint. So this is a butt weld joint, and basically it's like this. So now they have mentioned that the yield strength is sigma y is equals to 500 MPa, sigma ultimate is equals to 700 MPa. Now they have mentioned the thickness of plate is 8 mm, so they have mentioned the thickness as 8 mm and width as 20 mm. So basically width is in the plane of this question, so I am writing it as width 20 mm. Basically width is like this. If I do a 3D view like this, so this portion is width, basically it's 20 mm. Now they have mentioned that improper selection of welding parameters caused an undercut of 3 mm depth. So this is what I was trying to show you, that this is an undercut. Actually if the welding is proper, it should look like this, but since they have mentioned that there is a undercut of 3 mm, so what they are trying to say is that this portion is 3 mm, so this portion becomes 5 mm, since this is 8 mm. So now what they are asking, the maximum transverse tensile load in kilonewton carrying capacity of the developed weld joint. So they are basically asking the maximum load. So I am denoting by F maximum, which is equals to sigma ultimate into 5 into 20, because the welded portion is only now 5 mm due to undercut. So 5 and 20 is the width. So putting all the values 700 into 5 into 20 gives us 70,000 Newton, since 1 megapascal equals 1 Newton per mm square. So it's become 70 kilo Newton. So the right answer, they have, since they have asked the question in kilo Newtons, that's why 70. So right answer is 70. Now moving to the next question. So now this is a question from GATE 2015. So they have asked, in a linear arc welding process, the heat input per unit length is inversely proportional to. See friends, basically this is question can be solved if we know the formula also, or we can use logic also. So see, if we go for the formula, heat input per unit length, which is denoted by basically VI by velocity. So V is basically voltage, I is current, and V, this is welding speed. So if we go through the question, they have asked, in a linear arc welding process, the heat input per unit length is inversely proportional to. So we can see from this relation that it is inversely proportional to welding speed. So the correct answer is C. If we try to solve it logically, if by any chance you might not be knowing the formula, you can solve it logically also. See, what they're saying, the heat input per unit length. So if we increase the welding speed, so the we are spending less time at a particular area. So if we are spending less time at a particular area, so the heat input will also be less. So the question, if we read through the question, we will see that as we increase the welding speed, the heat input per unit length will start decreasing. So while reading the question and reading the options also, we can say that the correct answer is option C. Now moving to the next question. So see, this is again a GATE question from the year 2015. Now what the question says, a DC welding power source has a linear voltage current characteristics. So you might be knowing, or you have studied in the theory, that a linear voltage current characteristics is shown by this curve, V by I curve. You might be knowing, or you have might have studied in BTech, where this point is known as open circuit voltage, I am saying it as OCV, and this point is known as short circuit current. Since we know from the equation of straight lines, it can be written as this particular line can be written as V by OCV plus I by SSC is equal to 1 from the equation of straight lines. Now, what they have mentioned in this question, open circuit voltage they have given. So this is OCV is equals to 80 volt. They have given this as 80 volt. And they also given the short circuit current, which is equals to 300 ampere. So this is 300 ampere. Now this equation becomes V by 80 plus I by 300 is equals to 1. So now for maximum arc power, what they have asked, the current. So power, as we know, is written as V into I. It's a product of voltage into current. So from equation 1, I am writing the value of voltage in terms of current. So it is written as 80 times 1 minus I by 300. Let it be equation 2. So putting the value of equation 2 in the formula of power, we get power equals 80 times 1 minus I by 300 into I, which is 80I minus 80I square by 300. So now the question, which they have asked for maximum power. So for maximum power, we will differentiate with respect to the only variable which we have in this equation, which is I. So dp by di is equals to 0, and from this we will get the value of I. So differentiating, we get 80 minus of 80 into 2i by 300. So rearranging the terms and solving, we get I equals 150 ampere. So for maximum current, for the maximum arc power, the current which we are getting is a 150 ampere. So right answer is 150. Now moving to the next question. So as we can see that this is a question from the GATE year 2015. So now what the question says, that this is a TIG welding process. So basically TIG stands for tungsten inert gas welding process. Now the arc current and arc voltage they have mentioned, which is 50 ampere and 60 volts. So let us say that V is they have mentioned as 60 voltage and I they have mentioned as 50 ampere. When the welding speed was 150 mm per minute, so they have mentioned welding speed. I am writing it as V is equals to 150 mm per minute. Now they are saying that in another process, the TIG welding, the same welding, TIG welding is carried out at a welding speed of 120 mm per minute. So let us say this is V1. Now V2 they are saying it as 120 mm per minute, and what they have said, at the same arc voltage. So let us see, that this is V1, so V2 is also 60 volt, and the heat input is also same, so that the weld quality remains the same. So they are saying that, let us say this is H1 is something, say let's X. So and H2 is also same, so H2 is also X. Let us give I is as I1. Now what they are asking, the welding current in ampere. So basically what they have asked is I2 is equals to what. So in the previous video I have shown you that H, that is heat input, is basically denoted mathematically by the formula V into I by small v, which is welding speed. So we will use this relation to solve the question. So now from this relation we can see that V1 I1 by small V1 is equals to V2 I2 by small V2. Now we'll put all the values, 60 into 50 by 150 equals 60, because voltage is same, into I we have to find, because they have asked what is I, I2 divided by V2, which is 120. So 60 basically gets cancelled, 50 150, 3 times 3 and 120 40. So we get I2 as 40 amperes. So looking at the options, we see that I2 is 40, so option A is correct. So the correct answer is option A.